How are you?
Hey, Sheikh Mohammad, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How about you?
You are fine. How's that?
I'm fine, yes, I'm fine. Last time we have talked together, you have given me a exercise.
I gave an exercise?
Yes, to read that and that hadith.
Okay. And?
Because there are some hadith that I don't know, and I have read them.
All right.
And I found a few, not only a few, a bunch of hadiths and things that I don't searched, and I asked myself, why they have written such
embarrassing stuff.
I don't understand it really. Yeah. Why they have written such stuff?
Okay.
And then I had searched for many more things, and I have a question, which is important. You are a Christian.
Yeah.
Which one of the Christians is the truth one? Because of the Catholics, they are praying also to Maria and statues and things like that. There are the old Jews who have celebrated a cow and things like that. And which one of the Christians are the right Christians? I don't understand that.
Okay. Can I answer you now?
Yes.
Well, you know, there's nothing is called which one of them is right and which one of them is wrong. The one is right, doesn't matter which one. Which means if a church teaching something against the Bible, it is against the Bible, and that will make it wrong. But doesn't mean they make them wrong in everything. As an example, you mentioned that Catholic, they pray in front of a statues. That is absolutely wrong. But the Catholic don't pray to Mary. That's not true. You see, when the Catholic, the rosary is not a praying to Mary, the rosary is asking Mary to pray for them. So this is not accurate. You know, when people they say that to you, they are not being truthful. Same time, if I do something wrong, still I am a Christian, because this is what Christianity exists for. Because we are wrong, Jesus came, not because we are right. If everybody is right, then there is no need for Jesus to come. So Jesus,
that's right, yeah.
So Jesus did not come because we are right. Jesus came because all of us, we are wrong. So
yes.
If somebody is doing a wrong practice, that does not make Christianity wrong. That make the practice wrong. You know,
it seems to me like some of the Christians are believing wrong.
Well, you know, when you practice something wrong, obviously you believe in it, right? But that at the end of the day, the one who is doing that wrong, is he doing something really, I mean, let us say, he believe in Jesus as God, he believe in the crucifixion, he believe in the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. This is Christianity. The rest,
yes.
The rest is mostly is a tradition. It's not really a belief, because we don't find a base for it in any book, you know. Even the Bible says, don't make images for what is up in heaven or down in earth. Okay, so the Bible forbid us from even making images for the purpose of worship. So if somebody make those images for the purpose of worship, that is absolutely wrong. So this is his wrong. This is not Christianity being wrong. But doesn't mean that those people, they are not Christians. No, they are. But they practice something wrong. And there's not a single person in this earth don't practice something wrong. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Because this is our nature.
But
we are wrong.
How I can know which is right?
Very easy. The Bible is there. Whatever Jesus said is what is right. Very easy. You know, even
and which one I can. But
There's nothing is called which one. Bible is the Bible. There's nothing is which one. We have many translations, yes, but the Bible is one book. The translation
but
can be different.
You have to have a community. You know what I mean?
No.
Which community is the right one?
No, my community is Jesus, not the community. The community needs Jesus, not Jesus needs the community. So if you follow, you follow Jesus, you don't follow a community. We are not a tradition. We are not a tribe. We are not a corporation. We are not an organization. All of us, we belong to one Lord. His name is the Messiah. So if you are looking for community, you are wrong, because all community in the world are wrong. This is why we have sin everywhere. This is why we have crimes everywhere. So you will find even a priest is a child molester like Muhammad, correct? Okay.
Yes.
So how he can be a priest and a child molester? Because simply Satan exists everywhere. The Lord, he says, be aware of false teachers. They will come to you in the clothes of a sheep, but they are wolves. So always those who they are trying to make you go in the wrong, they dress as sheep. They don't come to you usually as a wolf, because if they come to you as a wolf, you will shoot them, right? So what they will do, they will dress as a sheep. So you will think they are a sheep. Then you trust them, and then you enter. They make them enter your house. So
yes,
you, as a person who's asking questions, you do not need to trust Christian prince in order to know Christianity. You need to trust only one person. His name is Jesus. Because who said that me, myself, I'm not a sinner?
But how can I ask? I don't get an answer.
No, you don't.
And the problem with the problem with my ding believing system, I have think a lot of them for the last days. And I thought, since I was a kid, I have learned everything I know from my grandmother, from my granddad, and then from imams in mosques and stuff like that, but they never showed me such stuff. And then I don't want to believe in it. And I saw more and more and more, and then I asked myself, why they are not showing that to me. I thought for a week ago, I thought my believing way is right, because I am not a liar. I am follow things straight on the things that I know. But these things, I don't know anything about it. And then I have seen it, and I ask myself, why never imam have showed me them or stuff like that.
So you know, Muhammad, you know, are you telling me you are thinking to leave Islam?
I don't know, really, I don't know. But there's an emotion in me, and it says to me, maybe it's false.
Maybe. Okay, how I can help you to confirm that it is not maybe, it is for sure cult. Let me ask you.
I don't know. Okay, I don't know how you can help me. Okay. I want only to know from you, because of this, because many of the Christians are worshipping statues and things like that.
No. Muhammad, there is not a single Christian, even the Catholic.
I know one thing for real. I know only one thing for real, Christian. Mm-hmm. I know only one thing for real, that Jesus, Isa, is more, I don't want to say holy or stuff like that, but he lived a life without sin, with miracles, no war, never killed a person, never do a sin. And I think he's a good person who can, to follow is right. To follow such a person, it was very right. It was nothing wrong with that.
Okay,
sure. That's what I know for sure. That's only the ones I know for sure is that.
Okay. But you see, you have a wrong information about Christians. I just told you that people they do wrong doesn't mean they are worshipping statues. If somebody, let us say, somebody pray in front of a picture, if he believe that that picture is God, then he is worshipping that picture. You know what I mean? If he pray in front of a statue, let us say, and he believe that a statue is God, then that make him for sure a pagan, and he have nothing to do with Christianity. But if somebody, I'm not trying to defend them, by the way, I believe this is all wrong, but I'm explaining to you why they do. Not because they believe that is God, they feel, you know, some people, they carry something from previous, you know, many they converted to Christianity, and they carry from them from the previous pagan practice, some pagan practice. So we do not need the statues, and statues have nothing to do with God. This is Christianity. But as long a person who don't believe that the statue is God, that does not make him really worshipping a statue, because he is not praying to the statues really, because he knew that this is just a statue. You hit it by a hammer, you can break it.
But if you say this, then you why are you talking negative about the Kaaba?
Oh, this is different, because Jesus never said to us to do.
Why this is different?
Hold on, it's different because Muhammad is the one who was kissing the black stone. So if Jesus was praying in front of his statues, then I would say I cannot blame the Christians who do wrong, you know, practice, because it's Jesus who told them. But Jesus never said that, right? But Muhammad is the one who kissed the black stone, correct?
Yes, but he don't know the stone is God.
Doesn't matter. You see, he is kissing it. Actually, this is more ugly, because there's no reason a person who somebody make a statue, let's say, for Mary, and he's asking Mary to pray for him. He's not even praying to Mary. He's asking Mary to pray for him. That is, you know, this is very wrong and have nothing to do with the Christianity. But he is not following God by practicing that. But when a Muhammad, he do kiss the stone, and there's no explanation. You ask all Muslims, why Muhammad kiss the stone? Can you tell me?
Because the people earlier days have done it.
No, so you follow people. You are a prophet of God. You brought monotheism. The people before, they did that because they are pagan Arab, supposedly. And now, supposedly, you are
a person. But the Christianity have also took some things from the old, from their old days, from the previous days.
Like what?
And took the stamp of Christianity on it.
Like what?
How they call it in Christianity, with water, to put a man down in water and then he is a Christian.
Baptism, right?
Baptism, yes.
No. You see,
written before Christianity.
Where?
That was there.
Was written where?
That was before Christianity.
Okay, where?
You can read it too.
Obviously you do not know what Christianity is. Christianity is not when Jesus came. Christianity is from the time of Adam, because all the purpose of mankind is to believe in Jesus. So all mankind, they are waiting for Christ to come, and Christ, he came. So Christianity exists from the beginning. So if Adam was a person who spoke to God and God spoke to him, then God, he gave Adam rules. And those rules, you know, we don't have full details of them, but we have a simple story about God told him not to do that, which is supposed to eat him from the tree. But I believe the story is more complicated than just a tree, because do you think really God, he cared for a tree? No. God, he cared for being obedience or not. So Adam, he disobeyed. So obviously God, he gave Adam order. And then Adam, when he came to this earth, he told his children about God. They are not ignorant. So knowing the true God exists from the first man, not by when Jesus came as a human.
Yes.
From the first man, they knew about God, and God gave them rules, and God gave them knowledge, and God told them, and God sent messengers. And all those messengers is to prepare for Jesus. So for you, you might think, okay, well, the baptism must be, you know, if you read the Bible, actually, you will see that John the Baptist, that's why they call him John the Baptist, right?
Jesus never wanted someone to baptize other peoples.
No.
He never wanted stuff like that.
No. He himself, he got baptized. Don't say things without knowledge. So Jesus himself,
as the baptized himself, only stands in the thing, in the thing, how they call it, bribe, letter. Which letter is the one?
What is that?
I
don't understand what you're saying. What letter?
I have read a lot about that and watched a lot of videos about Jesus himself doesn't want anybody else to baptize people.
When somebody says to you something, give it to me to show you that this is false. This is not true. Jesus, you know, the Bible says, go and teach and baptism in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Now, listen.
In the Hebrew letter, it says...
In the Hebrew letters, all the disciples of Jesus, they speak about baptism. If we go right now to any website, have the Bible translation, just type the word baptism, you will see it all over. So this is a false argument.
Yeah. The disciples have baptized, but not himself.
What do you mean he's not himself?
Not by himself. He doesn't baptize people.
This is why he did. Simply, you see the baptism.
He did it, but not with water.
He did it with what?
Not with water.
With what?
With Holy Spirit.
With the Holy Spirit. The baptism is the Holy Spirit baptism. The water is symbolic, how you are washing yourself from previous belief, pagan belief.
For example, John has baptized with water, and Jesus have baptized with Holy Ghost, and his disciples have baptized with water too.
Okay, hold on. See, Jesus himself, when he got the baptism, is an additional, let us say, signal or message for those who they are following him, the disciple, and everybody is watching, that he is the one people are watching for. This is why when the baptism happened, a voice came from heaven saying, this is my only begotten son, right? So this is not a baptism really, as much as a confirmation that this is the Messiah people they are waiting for. Same time, Jesus himself, when he did baptize, he's saying us that you need to be baptized too, as to be a new born again, which means you as a person who has became a following Christ, in order to receive the Holy Spirit, you know, you have to do baptism. And the baptism is not about the water. The baptism is about you confirming, announcing yourself as a Christian. And by doing that and washing all your previous belief, that will make you a new person. This is why we Christians, we believe in you like born again. And I'm sure you heard it many times from Christians. Okay. Born again Christian. Born again Christian is not a Protestant, is not a Catholic, is not Orthodox, is anyone who accepts Jesus as his Savior and he decides to start a new life. Because you are born as a baby, maybe from a Muslim family like you, maybe from a Christian
need
family.
Water or something like that. You have only to say it.
No. You see, you know, this is your opinion, but I can show you an example that it's not what make you save is the baptism by the water. As an example, when there was a person next to Jesus on the cross,
yes,
and then he said he believed in Jesus, and Jesus he promised him to go to heaven. This guy he did not do.
Yes, I know this. I have read
okay.
this.
Okay, this guy he did not get baptism. This guy he did not go in the water. He just said, I believe in you, all right? Okay. But this is for a person who have no choice to be baptized. This person is dying in the cross. So when we say baptism is necessarily, baptism is because Jesus, he told us that you announce yourself. The one who deny me, I deny him. This is what Jesus said. The one who deny me, okay, I deny him. So the baptism is like announcement that I don't deny Jesus and I'm willing to take the risk. Even if he kill me, I'm not going to say Jesus is not my God. So by doing such an act, you are receiving the gift of God that you became his child. But doesn't mean that you cannot receive it. Let's say you live in Saudi Arabia and there is nobody to do baptism for you. So, and you accepted Jesus. And I have many of them, tons of them who accepted Jesus and they live in Islamic countries and there's nobody there to baptize them. What, that they will die and they are not believers? No, they will die as a believers. But if you get a chance to be baptized, then you should do the baptism. And the baptism is, let us say, is an act of worship to Christ too. Why? Because when I say I am a Christian, and a Christian means following Christ, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Christ himself get baptized. So should I baptize too? Absolutely. Christ, he baptized to confirm to us that he is the Christ, which he is, which the whole world is waiting for him. And even the one who baptized him, he announced that. And even the heaven announced
John.
That. Yeah.
John has baptized him. Yes.
Yes. Yes. But as you see, John, before Christ, as you said, he was baptizing. This is why he's called John the Baptized, the Baptist. So, but doesn't mean that John, he was a pagan. John is a person, he's a great prophet of God, the same God, right? So when somebody say to you that baptism is something, is kind of a tradition, is et cetera, they can say that as they wish. But for us, it's something more than a tradition, is something spiritual. It is something unique. It is something I believe is beautiful too. Because, you know, there is a point in life when you change direction, and that point is going to be a point of history for you. Maybe it means nothing for somebody else, but for you, it's a point of history. Your life changed, and this is exactly what the baptism is. You know, you switch.
But you don't have to.
I understand it right, but you
it's
don't
not
doesn't
Muhammad,
have
Muhammad,
need to.
Muhammad, Muhammad. It's not up to you to say you don't have to, you have to, you know, this is not up to you. If you want to follow
Yes.
Christianity, this is what Jesus did, and so you do what Jesus did. If you don't accept, then you don't have to be a Christian too. It's not up to you to decide what is a Christianity or is not. I just gave you an example of a man who was dying on the cross next to Jesus. He was saved without being baptized, but he was on the cross. So if your scenario is the same as that person and you believe in Jesus, you are saved. Okay? So now if you are a person who believe in Jesus and you have a chance to baptize, give me a reason why not to do it, if Jesus did it.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus, he fast. Well, do God need to fast? No. But he fast, so we
No.
fast. So that means fasting is something good. Fasting is something very, very unique. Fasting is you fighting your temptation, your you know, all the things around you. So Jesus himself, he fast. For sure, you cannot fast like him, you know. You cannot fast for 40 days without food and water. Nobody can do that. But you can Yes. fast still, and you can practice a human being fasting, a normal human being fasting, so you can fight your struggle. But it's not fasting will save you. Fasting
Yes.
will help you to be saved from temptation and etc. To control yourself. It's a training of self-control. Same time, it's you refusing everything around you to disturb you from being with God. So everything have a reason, and if you don't want to accept those reasons, then don't accept Christianity. You know, we are not the same as Muslims. They practice hypocrisy. When they want, it's okay. When they want, it's not okay. As an example,
yes, sir, no.
You know, fornication is haram, right? But then we do muta, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or we do zawaj al-misyar, or we do zawaj a friend, you know, marry a friend. You know, you go one night in the hotel once a week or twice a month, and that's supposed to be marriage. So, you know, the Islam is a religion of tricks, not religion really of rules, because all the rules
Why
have
they,
a trick.
That's my question. Can you give me an answer of that? Why they never told, for example, to me, stuff like that? Why I have to read it by myself? I have learned it by imams and sheikhs since I was a kid, since I was 5 or 4 years old, and never someone showed me stuff like that. Never. I have learned it all by heart. I can recite everything by heart, but I don't know about the other things. Why they have never?
Okay,
why
I will
they
tell
never
you,
show something like that?
I will
why?
Tell you a problem you have.
I have lost. Maybe I have lost 30 years of my life. Maybe.
Yeah, Sheikh Ahmed Muhammad, you last time when Abbas was talking, you recite for us some chapters, correct, by heart.
Yes.
Okay, one of them is about magic. Is it?
Magic?
Yeah. Which one you
recited? You mean Nas?
Yeah.
Close up in Nas?
Uh-huh.
You mean this?
Okay, can you say this chapter for us?
Close up Rabbin Nas, Melikin Nas, Ilayin Nas, Min Sharin Fasfasil Han Nas, Elazi Yuvas Fisu Fisudurin Nas, Min El Cinneti Fen Nas.
What does that mean? Nothing. Stupid.
As they
stupid Quran.
As they told it to me, I have to pray this one and Falak.
Hmm.
When I go to sleep and
no.
Someone,
I'm asking you
something
what
bad
this mean.
Happens.
This is another question. What does that mean? Silly, stupid. I mean, how you spend 30 years and you do not ask yourself how stupid this is?
They have taught me in which situations I have to pray this. They have taught me this.
Okay, no problem, but this is stupid. You know, who is the, what is waswas and what is khannas? This is just very stupid. This is silly. And then he says, among the genie, what is that? You know, so you will find that this is just empty words, have nothing, you know, Muhammad is trying to make a rap song, which is very silly. And it's not even to be made for kids. So, you know, when you recite it, you say, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ. What is that, مَلِكِ النَّاسِ? All right, I hope, let us see, guys, you hear me now? Am I heard now? All right, I apologize. What we can do, we lost our internet and our conversation totally lost. So I had to restart my modem to make it work. We will try to contact Mr. Mohammed again. Give me a second, please. Please invite your friends here. We go like, you know, we lost 1,000 people, but just because we our connection is gone for a few seconds. All right, I see he's... Okay, look like he is not there right now. Hello?
Your connection is there.
Yeah, well, you know, I did recite the chapter, you know, seek refuge by Allah from the waswas, and the internet came back.
So, I thought maybe that's a sign or something like that.
A sign. Okay. That's a good one.
Really, this can be a big problem for me, you know? Can be a problem
for
me.
So you are a superstition person?
Like what?
Well, you know, you said it's a sign for you. What is the sign? That we lost our internet?
I don't know. Maybe to cut you. I don't know.
But he could not cut me. Here we go. I'm back.
I know.
So do you think this God Allah?
This can be a
I will go with you, Mr. Problem. So you think that now Allah, he lost the fight because I restarted my modem?
No.
Yeah, this is what happened. I just restarted my modem and everything is fine.
I said to you, restart your modem. I said it to you.
I know. But if Allah is the one who cut me off, well, I just cut off Allah. Because based on what you're saying, Allah is trying to cut me off. And I respond to Allah by cutting him off, by restarting the modem.
Yes.
Why Allah make me, win and he lose then? And I'm getting him busted for tens of years. I mean, that's not 10, not 20 more. So this is how Allah, he make war now. He cut my modem. Is Allah the one who made the internet? Okay, I will go with you. Muhammad, he recited this verse, right?
Yes.
Okay, and then Muhammad, he recited other verse about magic. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Did Muhammad was controlled by magic?
I read something like that.
What do you mean you read?
I think three days ago I have read something like that. He was on magic for 40 days, stuff like
so
that.
So obviously Allah is a false God, because here we go. Muhammad, he said to you, if you recite this chapter, which is made supposedly to fight magic, black magic, you will not have magic. Muhammad, he says, if you eat 7 ajwa, no magic can affect you and no poison can kill you. And he have both.
Yes.
Okay, so now Muhammad, was he reciting the Quran?
Yes.
Every day, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so every day reciting the Quran did not protect him from black magic. So the Quran cannot stop anything. Allah cannot stop anything. Last time I spoke to a Muslim sheikh, he said it took Allah 12 months to release Muhammad from the magic. I said, why? He said, because Allah, he made for him, Shaitan, he made for him, or the magic, was made in 12 knots. So now you are a person who believe that I can make a knot for you, and now I can control you from far distance, correct?
Yes.
Okay. What do you think? Is that smart or something stupid?
This is way more than this.
What more than this? What?
I can't say this is smart or stupid or stuff like that because this is real magic and this
Okay,
is
why
really.
Muslim? Okay, why? So, okay, hold on. Why people don't control those leaders in the world? I mean, if you can control somebody by a knot, can I
This
control
was better.
the? So we can control people then by a knot. So your prophet is a voodoo person. He's a pagan because voodoo is a paganism. You are the one we're talking about paganism and doing not something not having to do with God. So when you do so such a thing, such a practice, obviously you are pagan. And when Muhammad, he says, if you read this chapter, then nobody can make a knot for you. So why, how come the Jewish guy, he made a knot for Muhammad and he controlled him? And always they blame the Jews for anything.
I don't know why.
No, because obviously this is fiction, this is lie. This guy is a mental ill. He blame everything for the Jews. So he, you know, he is a crazy. So they say he was bewitched. As simple as that. Who's going?
I think who does he have diseases? I have to tell it to you from our first talk.
Yeah, this is not a disease. This is this the disease is something.
And because
can,
he have sex with
yeah,
100 women.
That is a sexual disease. But here we are talking about mental illness. So,
but it makes you crazy in the head too.
I don't know if that will
it
happen from a sexual
crazy.
Disease. I'm not expert with sexual diseases. So my friend, what confirmed to us that Muhammad was, according to Muslims, not according to us, he was bewitched, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So the man who saw it said to you, if you read Quran, Satan cannot bewitch you. How come the Quran did not work with him and he is the one supposedly protected by his God?
Doesn't make sense.
Doesn't make sense. So he's a fraud. And not only that, as long as Muslims agree that Muhammad was deceived, that you see the title of our video is who is the one is deceived, Christians or Muslims? The story in front of us proves that Muhammad was deceived. Because when you control somebody by a black magic, the Muslim believe in black magic, that means he was deceived. Because what black magic mean, you are not in control of what you do, and you do wrong things. So he was deceived, according to the Muslims, not according to me. So how the one is under the black magic, he is deceived, how he can be the one I trust to guide me?
Yeah.
So Muhammad is false. If you come to me with a saying, a prayer like this will save you, and then you yourself, you are under the influence of what you taught me, I can be saved from. That means you are not even praying. So there's one of two solutions. Either Muhammad, he never read Quran, he was a false person, because the Quran protect him if he is reading it. Or Muhammad was reading the Quran, and the Quran is a false book, and that's why he wasn't protected from the black magic. Correct?
My mind is flipping around.
Well, Muhammad, he said, as an example, Muhammad is a doctor too, and Allah told him medicine. The Muslim, they call it the Prophet medicine, Allah medicine. Muhammad, he said, he who eat seven ajwa, seven date fruit, every morning will not be affected
and
by poison
you.
And magic. Okay, but Muhammad,
yes,
he had both.
I know this.
Muhammad, he died by poison, and he was infected by magic. Okay, so how?
I know.
So his
cutting
Quran. So his Quran is not working. His ajwa is not working, and he is a false teacher. Everything happened is against, you know.
Actually, is against his own teachings.
Somebody saying in the chat, Christian Prince. I got you wrong. Sorry, he said Jesus could not be even tempted. That's true. You see, the Muslims sometimes they go and they say that Satan, when he come to Jesus, he tempt Jesus. Tempt is an act, but are you tempted? So Jesus, he never been under the influence of the temptation. Here you see Muhammad, according to the Muslims, and this is his wife saying that the prophet, he is imagining things, and in fact he did not. Why? Because he was bewitched. But who would believe in this? If we believe in it, it's a disaster. If we don't believe in it, it's more funny. Because if Muhammad really was bewitched by black magic, then he is satanic messenger, because as long as Shaitan is controlling me, I am a, then I will be a messenger for Shaitan. So Muhammad was speaking for more, according to Muslim, this is happening for a year. So for one yes. year of the life of Muhammad, how many verses came from Shaitan? And how a messenger of God, he was under the control of Shaitan all this time, and Allah did not do anything about it. And where is the Quran to protect him? So what do you think? If I am you, I will leave Islam right away. You yourself, you say it, there is no one like Jesus. We have no sin. And you know, the second you say that, you accepted him as God, because every human being do sin. There's no human being, including me, including you, including anyone. Every human being is a sinner, except Jesus. So Jesus, he came in the flesh as a human being, but in fact, he is God in the flesh. And this is why he have no sin. Otherwise, he should have sin like all of us. So yes. if I am you, Sheikh Muhammad, I will accept Jesus right now as we speak, as Lord, as Savior. And obviously, Muhammad, he cannot save himself. Here we go, Shaitan controlling him, and he have no solution for it. So, do you accept the Lord, the Messiah, as your Savior, Sheikh Mohammed? He hung up. He hung up. You don't want to see a moment of truth. Let us call him again. Yes, Muhammad, how are you? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, I hear you. Go ahead. What you send me in the chat, I want people to hear what you said.
Hello?
You hear me?
Hello?
You don't hear me now?
Hello?
Let me call you back. We lost you again. It says unavailable. No, I think you have a bad connection. Well, he is welcome to call. Hello?
Can you hear me?
Yes, Muhammad, I hear you. Sheikh Muhammad, how are you?
Yes.
So, I saw a text from you. I want people to hear what you decide. What you decide?
I accept it.
I accept what?
I accept Jesus as my Savior.
I mean to that. Hallelujah. We are so happy to Sheikh Muhammad. He is the best sheikh, and now he is going to be the best Christian. Praise the Lord.
I have a real big problem about now.
What is your problem?
I have to leave this country.
You will find your way.
Maybe, yes.
You will find your way, no problem. You know, always the Lord, he opened doors, my friend. So we are happy for our friend. Please, all of you, put him in your prayer. Our friend Sheikh Muhammad, he decided to accept Jesus as his Lord and as his Savior. And this
I accept it because I know there is something who is true about Jesus.
That's the reason, because, but I don't, I asked for him many days, many nights, but still he don't show himself to me.
What happened today?
Today?
Yeah. Well, you accepted him today.
I made a decision today.
What made you make the decision? Just because he's good?
I made this decision because I struggle with myself to believe in such a stuff.
So, you know, Islam doesn't make any sense. Islam is silly. Islam is stupid. And now you have an option of Christ, which is a very extremely amazing person. Correct?
But now I have more problems than before.
No, you don't. You have zero problem.
Problems, you are saying this.
No, no. You see, problems, they all exist as long as we see them as a problem. I find that sometimes problems are the best things happen to us. You see, everything happened to me in my life, which I thought it was a problem. It turned to be something good for me.
You are not in my position right now.
My friend, you can, you know, if being in that country, you can leave that country, whatever country you are in. This is not really, this is temporary problem. Secondly, you know, the Lord, he says, they don't fear those who destroy the body, fear those who destroy the soul. So your soul is saved and you accepted the Messiah as your Lord, as your Savior. The second step is read more the gospel, get close to the Lord, and find your way out of this country because your life is insecure there. And you know what? Things happen for a good reason. Maybe the Lord, he want to send you to a different country so you can be a person, a disciple, to speak of him, to bring more Muslims. You see, the lady, she called me. She was saying about a prophet in the Bible, Ayub. You know Ayub, right? So Ayub,
this girl is lost.
Yeah. But Ayub, he's struggling because he's a good person. Not like Muhammad. Muhammad struggling from what? Too many women? Too much money? Too much filth? I mean, this guy is obviously, he's mentally ill and he is filthy. So, you cannot compare
I'm
between
sorry
this
for
and
the
that.
Black guy. I'm sorry for the black guy who have called you. I'm sorry for him because...
He will leave Islam, trust me. All of them, they call in the beginning. You see, just 2 months ago, I have a seminar, and all who attend my seminar, they are black people. There's only two white people. All of them, they are either from Nigeria. Most of them, actually, there's Nigeria. There's other, you know, African countries. But all of them, they were shocked, and they could not believe that this is what Islam is about. I asked one of them, I remember, what do you think about Islam? He says, the good thing about Islam, it teach self-respect. And then after...
If he has self-respect, then he don't join Islam.
No, he's not a Muslim.
Living here. I have many black people around me, but they are slaves.
Islam make you a slave, even if you are black or white.
They are slaves.
Yeah, Islam is a religion of slavery.
They are real slaves. We are slaves too for Allah, but they are slaves. Yeah, for us.
Yeah, well, I'm so happy for you, Muhammad. You know, I ask all the Christians here to pray to our brother Muhammad to know the truth more and to get close to the Lord. And I advise you to read the Bible, the Gospel. You can start from the Gospel of John. And read carefully and don't read by your lips. Read by your heart. Live the story. Don't read the story. We are not Muslims who recite and memorize empty words. The Bible is not Quran. Quran is an empty, false statement, mean nothing. They don't even make sense. The verse before it doesn't make sense with the verse after it, etc. So read from with your heart, live the story, don't read words, live the words. This is my advice for you. If there's anything you want to say to the people that are listening to you as a message from you.
Don't make holidays in Syria or stuff like that.
Is that what make you go there? You went to do holiday and then you stuck?
No, I don't make holiday here.
Hmm.
I went to Syria because I can live here under Islamic law. Yes, that's all.
All right. Well, my friend, I will be happy to receive more calls from you. And if you have Muslim friends, they can call me. It's time for me to go. I'm here for long, and I have some work to do.
If I tell them to call you, maybe they kill me.
Okay, well, tell them to call me after you leave the country, not now. All right?
Take care.
All right. Take care, my friend. God bless you. Take care. Well, we are happy to our friend Muhammad who decided to leave Islam. And I hope that the lady who she called, I feel sorry for her. She is trying to give all kind of excuses to the false prophet. Nobody can excuse that. How we can even, I cannot, you see, I don't want to say, can I compare between Muhammad and Jesus? That is an insult to my Lord.